local author, nurse, and humanitarian aid worker. Roberta Gately has stopped by our program to talk about a special presentation that she has coming up at the library this month. It's called Making a Difference, One Woman, One Story at a Time, Wednesday, December 18th, 7 to 8:30 p.m., and we're going to learn all about it right now. Welcome, Roberta.
Hi, thanks so much for having me.
Thank you for coming over. Really appreciate it. So nice to know that we have in our midst right here in Quincy a multiple author and also somebody who's traveled around the world pretty much. Tell us a little bit about yourself.
I have. Well, I'm a nurse, so I'm a nurse first. And I think as so many nurses, I always wanted to do aid work. Every time you see a compelling shot on television of another tragedy or disaster, for many in healthcare, our first instinct is to go and to help. Mm. And I first went over 25 years ago during the Soviet invasion of Afghanistan, and really fell in love with the work and the people and just the good that you can do. And I've done it on and off ever since. In between my stint, mostly in the ER at Boston City, now Boston Medical Center.
And your experiences prompted you to write about them.
Yep. Also, another thing I've always done since I was little is to write. And I wrote about all of my aid trips for nursing journals. And when I was in Darfur, I wrote for the BBC Online. When I was in Iraq, a New York Times reporter told me I should write a book. I'd been waiting to hear that my whole life.
Yeah.
So I came home and got started. It sounds easy to put it into a nutshell, but got an agent. And my publisher is now Simon & Schuster. My second novel came out just a year ago.
Wow. So what will this particular presentation at the library entail?
This presentation, my first and second novel, Lipstick in Afghanistan and The Bracelet, are really the behind-the-scenes stories. On the news, we see veiled women in Afghanistan or Pakistan or even Darfur living lives that we think are so miserable and deprived. And, well, they often are. There are also lives filled with hope and resilience. And the stories in my books, in both novels, include women from those parts of the world who become friends with American women and who really overcome the problems in their own lives.
So hence the topic, One Woman, One Story at a Time. So you're telling it through their eyes, through their experiences?
In my first book especially, Lipstick in Afghanistan, has sections. Elsa is the Boston nurse from the ER who goes to Afghanistan after 9/11. Mm. And there she meets Parween, who has her own separate section in the book until they meet. And Parween is a young Afghan girl who's fed up with the Taliban and her country's backward ways. And she's ready to throw off the veil and fight for women everywhere and for freedom and for what's right. Mm-hmm. And it's the story of their friendship. And also because every book, so both of mine do, should have a little romance, it's the story of an American Special Forces soldier who falls in love with Elsa, and it's their relationship as well. And it's really how the three of them find their way through the times in Afghanistan and forge friendships. Mm-hmm.
Are they based on true stories, Roberta?
Elsa is based on me. I went to Afghanistan after 9/11. I'd been there many times before. Mm. But going back then gave me a special perspective. And the main Afghan character, Parween, is a tough little customer who's based on a little girl that I used to see in my village in Afghanistan. I lived in the village and worked in a clinic and then mobile clinics. And when I would walk in the morning through the irrigation fields and across the road to the hospital, I often saw a little girl who was always pulling off her veil. She was about 6 years old, to pummel one little boy or another. And although in Boston or Quincy, an episode like that would give me pause and I would want to step in and stop it, in Afghanistan, I admired her courage.
Yeah.
Because even now, she is probably a veiled woman and her life is much different. But that little girl got out her desire for freedom and equality every single day when she was a kid. And I loved that trait of hers.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Do you keep in touch with her or any other?
I don't. Okay, I do keep in touch with a few people from Afghanistan.
Yeah, yeah.
Actually, when I gave them my telephone number in Quincy,
right?
Never thinking that they would get to a phone.
Right.
But one of them, actually two of them, I guess, got to Kabul. And called me, and I came home from work one day when I'd come home after I'd been home from Afghanistan for a while. And I hadn't told them about answering machines.
Okay.
So they got my answering machine with my voice saying to leave a message, and then the beep. So when I picked up the phone and hit message, I got this, Roberta? Roberta? Is that you?
Thinking you were there.
Speak, speak. It was great.
You probably saved that message, I'm sure, right?
I did.
So you'll be telling stories like that, and you'll have your books available at this presentation.
And,
And photographs, perhaps?
There's photographs on my website,
okay.
RobertaGately.com, a whole gallery of photos. But I actually do at my presentation, I have a PowerPoint presentation that I show that's pretty popular.
Sure.
I actually showed it. I was asked to speak at one of the Marine balls last year, and I showed the PowerPoint there, and it was very well received.
Yeah. Any new writings in the works right now?
I finished my third book,
Next
of Kin, and it's in its final edits and revisions.
Very good. Congratulations on that.
Thank you.
We'll look forward to that. And to your presentation. Thanks for stopping by.
Thanks. Thanks so much for having me. I hope people can make it.
You're very
Wednesday
welcome.
Wednesday the 18th.
Again, it is Making a Difference, One Woman, One Story at a Time. Quincy author and humanitarian aid worker and nurse, Roberta Gately, Wednesday, December 18th, 7 to 8:30 at the Thomas Crane Library. There's information on their website, thomascranelibrary.org.